welcome to the Bestie Lefties podcast, and thank you for coming.
I'm Amanda, and you can find me on Instagram and Ravelry as a handicraft home.
And I'm Jessica. You can find me on Instagram and Ravelry as Stitchcrafty. And you can also find me as a teacher on knitchats.com.
And we are both left-handed knitters and crafters.
Yeah. So welcome to the first episode of our podcast. We hope you enjoy it. We will have timestamps down below so that you can decide what you want to watch and what you don't want to watch if you're not interested in sewing or the hand stitching or anything like that. There will be spinning content later through the episodes. There's not this time. I don't have any spinning. We will have a giveaway in this podcast as well, so stick around. I have 5 kids, ages ranging in 12 down to 2, and we homeschool. I am a prolific knitter. I do a little bit of sewing, but I don't like it because I have kids that like to twist my tension knobs, especially my 2-year-old. But I mostly, you know, I sew out of necessity. My daughter prefers handmade clothing. She's been begging me to finish the rest of her 6 pairs of leggings that I have going for a few months now. So, I do some crochet, I do spinning, and a little bit of hand stitching every now and again.
I have 5 kids as well, and we also homeschool. They are ages 9, 7, 6, 4, and 3 months. And she's right over here, so I keep looking at her. And I've been sewing for about 8 years, consistently for about 8 years. And I've been knitting for 17 days.
Thank you. Thank you to the Hey Sisters podcast, because you sew such cute stuff that I got her watching the podcast.
Yep.
And now she's converted to a knitter.
And then I got interested in the knitting, yes. Because I used to just skip to the sewing. But then there were such cute knitting things, especially for the recent babies. So, but she has been kind of, you know, trying to get me to do it for a while. So I'm really enjoying it.
I'm wearing Saturn Return by Amanda Hester Smith. I test knit the pattern for her, and it is just a fantastic knit. It was just released this week. I used Quince & Co. Phoebe in the Andromeda colorway. This particular pattern has a bottom-up construction where you work the lace detail. It is absolutely... It's such a relaxing knit. I was able to mostly knit it while visiting with my husband in the evenings. It's not really something you can take out and about because the chart isn't something you can memorize, but definitely enjoyable. The lace is, it's not super complicated. It's for an adventurous beginner or maybe an intermediate knitter. I love lace. Lace is my jam, as you can see back here. So it was really easy for me. It's on Ravelry. You can find it under Amanda Hester Smith Designs, I think. She has been so gracious to donate one free pattern for giveaway. For our podcast, you'll find us in the Bestie Lefties group on Ravelry and just go into the thread for me, although I did learn a few new stitches, so that's really good. So let us know in the Ravelry group under the giveaway thread what your favorite sweater construction is, whether it's pieced, knit, top-down raglan, bottom-up, or a drop shoulder. Let us know, and that will enter you into the giveaway. please don't comment on anybody else's comments because we'll have to delete those out. We just want one entry per person.
And I am wearing the Marianne dress by Christine Haynes. And she has a couple different options, different sleeve lengths. And you can do the contrasting yoke in the front and the back like I have here. Or you can just do all the same piece. One of her sleeve lengths has a cuff detail on it that has little buttons that you can put on. And that's really cute. This one is just the short sleeve. And the dress is a little bit on me. I'm pretty short, so on me it's a little bit above my knee. It might be mid-thigh on somebody who's a little bit taller, but it would probably be pretty easy to shorten if you wanted it shorter. And it was a nice pattern put together, and I think it's pretty cute. It's nice little, I just did it in a jersey knit, little dandelion kind of pattern for spring. And I'll put that link in the show notes if anybody's interested in the pattern.
Yeah, we'll put all of our yarns, fabrics, whatever you're interested in links down below, patterns, everything. So
yeah.
So I have a finished object. I finished my Christmas socks. They're a little longer, they're a little higher. They're ankle socks, I guess. I got tired of knitting, so I just quit. I like shorty socks anyway. So these are in the Perfect Stitch Company's yarn. She's on Etsy, and we'll put a link down below. I don't remember the colorway. It was something like, oh my goodness, I put a purl stitch in there. Or a knit front and back.
Oh.
So, I have a design feature. Well, okay, they're just vanilla socks, but yep. I'm gonna just, you know, have a little hole in there. They're going in my Christmas box of socks.
Yeah, I like that color.
Super cute box, but I love how it worked up. It is just, I like how it's spread out. Mm-hmm. It doesn't do any... heavy pooling, at least. You get these strikes, but that's about it. It was enjoyable to work with, you know, your basic 75-25. It's not high twist. And it has a little bit of stellina, so I think it was a 75-20 and then 5% stellina in it. A little bit of sparkle. I can't really get it to come across, so... And I knit them toe up. I did a fish lips kiss heel. And I'm not going to do a fish lips kiss heel anymore because, let's see, I think this was my first sock. And you can see how stretched out these top stitches are. And then my second sock, I added, let's see, I think I did 66 or 68 stitches on this sock. And with this one, I did 72. I don't care if they're the same size. I really just don't. I'm going to wear them around the house. I'm not going to wear them in shoes because I don't wear socks in the particular shoes that I wear for the most part. I have one pair of shoes that I wear out in public when the weather is gunky, and I'll wear socks in those. But my nice shoes, I don't wear socks with. So this one I did 72 stitches, and it still stretches out too far for the fabric. It's fine on the bottom of my feet, but for right there on my instep, it stretches out too much. And I couldn't really pinpoint the reason why, but I watched the Fruity Knitting podcast, and they interviewed Kate Atherley. She was talking about her Knit Socks to Fit Your Feet book. I think that's what it's called. I bought it because she talked so much about it. She talked about the fact that with the short row heel, it doesn't actually add any additional stitches in the circumference of the knitting, whereas like a heel flap and gusset would. So if you have a high instep, it's just not gonna work well for you. So I'm not gonna do that anymore because I don't like it. It's tight there, it's uncomfortable. I don't wanna rip them out and re-knit them. I've blocked them. I'm hoping it'll be better, but yeah.
I've only been knitting for 17 days, so I don't have any FFOs.
But you have some works in progress.
I do have some works in progress. Well, I have one. It's only like this big. This is just a bag I made. Nothing special.
We'll sew for yarn.
Don't think so.
No.
Oh.
But you will.
Yes.
We'll sew for yarn.
So I have... It's just this little bit here. This is the Easy Goes It Shawl by Finicky Creations. It's a free pattern on Ravelry.
It's a baby shawl.
It's very cute and little.
It is.
And I'm still learning like a bunch of different stitches, so.
Ooh, hold up your yarn.
And so my yarn is this.
It's so pretty.
Did it show up?
Is it showing? Like, how's that for the lighting? Is it blowing out?
It's just not focusing on it.
Come on.
It's focusing on my face.
Hiding.
Well, this is my yarn, and there, that's good.
Hey, that's perfect.
It's, this is the Gotta Have Shawls Fingering Weight by Artistic Lily on Etsy, and the colorway is Calamity Jane. And I'm really enjoying knitting with this. I have this pig leg string here.
Yeah.
It just feels really nice, and I'm really, yeah, that's all stupid, just cut that out. So, and I got my new needles the other day. It's a Chagu 6, I think it's a 6.
Yeah, that's a 6.
And,
4 millimeter.
I don't even know where it's at. But, I really like these ones. Hopefully I'll have some more than this little tiny piece. That I can't even really tell what's on there, but we'll work more. You have to show me how you did that.
I have a few works in progress. I have a sock, again, toe up because, you know, I didn't know Kitchener. This is actually a second sock, so here's my first. I don't have a pattern for it. It's just me. It's in Malabrigo sock in the eggplant and light of love, I think, colorway with my little pickle stitch marker.
Okay, so the colors are pretty.
I enjoy it, and she thinks that there's no other color besides purple and pink, so yeah. Although she's into black leggings lately, so I don't know. And this is the Pavement Sweater by Vera Valamaki. I'm finally motivated to get myself off of Sleeve Island. I actually knit this sweater, the body and everything, in 2017. And I've tried the sleeves a few different times. I keep getting that raglan hole and it just bothers me, so I tried a different way. I used smaller needles. I'm knitting on a US 7 right now, but I started the picking up the stitches on a US 4 and it worked out, and I picked up extra stitches. So I had this, you know, I picked up all my stitches I think the day before yesterday and did a little bit of knitting on it yesterday. I didn't really have a whole lot of time because it's spring and I was repotting plants.
It's finally spring in Nebraska.
Finally spring. Oh my goodness. It is.
It is no longer January 128th. Oh, whatever it would be.
It was so long. Oh, I'm so glad winter is over.
I'm still sewing winter clothes.
I'm still knitting winter.
Yeah.
Stuff.
It's like 70 something here today. So.
Yeah. Finally. Oh, and I didn't say. I'm knitting in Hue Loco, the We Love Cupcakes colorway, in her Phyllis sock base. I love it.
Oh, I love the colors in there.
Yeah.
She, I love that little purpley
blue.
She
does such a good job.
Yep, and that hot pink one.
And, well, I like the little bits of coral in it.
Yeah, the coral
as well.
Is really
pretty. Oh my goodness, but the sprinkles. Yeah. It's going to be a fun sweater to wear. I have the beeswax hat with my little grumpy cloud because spring wasn't here yet. I'm really enjoying this. I cannot wear this color, unfortunately. This is in Brown Sheep Prairie Spun DK, in their honeycomb colorway, which it actually has a bit of green tint to it.
Yeah.
Really, it's more of a Dijon mustard.
Yeah.
Right?
I would say, yeah.
Yeah. I'm not unhappy with it. I bought it because
it's a really pretty color. Yeah.
I've been wanting to knit this pattern since it came out.
Oh, I love that.
And,
sure.
Oh, so gorgeous. Yeah. Amy Vandelaar. And I have one more for knitting works in progress. I am knitting Ramble by Andrea Mowry. Another one of my favorite knitters. And designers. I'm in the herringbone section here.
So pretty.
So, and I actually finished my first chart repeat, so I have my progress keeper up here. My little holographic hippo that I made myself. Yeah. So hopefully it'll see more work. It's in Brown Sheep. Did I almost poke you? I'm so sorry. You don't need that eye anyway.
It's okay. I got my glasses. I got my, what do you call them? My safety glasses on.
Right. We should wear safety goggles.
Yeah.
In order to get it. Oh my goodness. So this is the Coneflower colorway. I don't know. It's not going to, is it going to blow out? Yeah.
Oh,
there we go.
Not too bad.
By Brown Sheep and half and half. Just white and purple-ish. Fuchsia? Not fuchsia. It's purpley.
Yeah, it's purpley.
It's a purpley fuchsia. Purple-leaning fuchsia.
It does remind me of Coneflower, actually. So.
Yeah. So.
Cat!
Sorry. Oh. And I'm making cool. A crochet blanket. I don't know what it's called. I'm crocheting the Cedar River blanket. This is my first square, and here's my second square, which when I finished it, I realized that I knit it, or crocheted it. You don't knit crochet, people. Don't knit crochet. Oh, at least I don't. Yeah, I didn't do enough rows of the beginning white and totally threw the rest of the colors off.
Mm-hmm.
It happens.
The colors are really pretty.
So it's going to have to be dishcloth. It's in Brown Sheep cotton fleece. Hmm. So it's a little bit of wool, but mostly cotton.
I like that.
So this will be a dishcloth, I think. Because I'm not ripping it out and then coming up too short with yarn and more tails to weave. And
a lot of tails.
Oh my goodness. Okay, so I have one question for everybody. If you're a crocheter, I hold my hook as if it's a knife, I think. Yeah, because I don't hold it like a pencil. I hold my tension, and whatever it is that I'm doing with my finger, it hurts so bad. it causes pain all up and down. So I can only crochet maybe half of one of these blocks in a day and maybe rest a couple of days and then crochet again. It came about because I was using Addi needles, and the Addi, is it Turbo Lace? It's something about them being so slick that I was holding my needles differently and it would shoot pain all up my arm. My knuckle got really swollen from it. So I quit using the Addis, but now I have problems with this tendon.
Ouch.
So when I tension my crochet, when I tension for my crochet, it really hurts. So any tips on being able to change how I hold my tension for crochet would be fabulous, because I want to be able to crochet more. I'm not a fast crocheter, so this blanket's going to take me a lot longer than I thought it was. So there's that.
That's all I have.
Shall we? Yeah, that's actually all I have for works in progress. Planning.
So the other thing that I have planned is the Malt blanket by Tin Can Knits, for my little baby. And I got this dishy yarn from Knit Picks in the conch color, or conch, however you like to say it. And I'm excited. I thought it would be kind of a good repetitive practice kind of thing for stitches for a newbie. So
I had to give her her second.
And it's warm now, so she probably doesn't need a blanket.
It's cotton though. It'll be perfect, even for summer. You know, when you need to maybe shade her or something like that.
Yeah, or at night. I get it really cold in the house.
Yeah, it does get cold in your house.
My husband sleeps under two blankets.
Yeah, I freeze in my house in the summer. It's a thermostat.
The basement and our house is cold.
Yeah, ours too.
So now
I have. Well, we can move on to planning.
Yeah,
we just did though a little bit earlier. I am planning the 1942 sweater by Maria Olson. This is in the brown sheet Prairie Spun DK. This is the half and half colorway, which, you know, like milk, half and half. I'll be swatching for it soon, but I'm trying to finish that pavement pullover. I stay on Sleeve Island forever. I'm going to do it as the 3/4 sleeve. I'm not doing short sleeve. So I want to finish that before I allow myself to cast on any other sweater.
Famous last words.
Right? It's knitting goals. It's just bribing myself to finish something.
Yeah.
Especially when it comes to sleeves, because sleeves take me longer to knit than the entire sweater. So, 1942, I'm so excited to get into this, and I'm hoping to finish it by August, September-ish. Because I want to wear it in the fall, if we have a fall. What if it stays hot super long?
It probably will.
It probably will.
It will be very hot until Thanksgiving, then it'll snow the next day. Love you, Nebraska.
We'll have a tornado, and then it'll snow the next day. I also am planning the Rhinecliff cardigan by Valerie Hobbs. Another super textured piece. I bought the Plucky Traveler DK in Torch Song, which is going to be impossible to show what it actually looks like.
It's not black.
It's not brown. It's not black. It is.
It's like a
purple, but red and black. Mm-hmm. So it's a warm leaning purple. So
it does have some.
It is. Oh, it's.
It's pretty.
Yeah. It's going to lend itself really well to the texture, I think.
I bet it will.
So, and Plucky DK, Traveler DK is...
I love how that feels, because I love that. Well, the hat that you made me. Her.
Yeah, that's in Plucky Primo.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I love how that feels.
Yeah, in the fingering. But Traveler is merino, silk, and yak. Ooh, that's going to be nice and warm.
Yeah.
So I'm really excited. And then I have some summer knitting that I'm planning. I may have gone a little crazy with the Quince & Co., but I bought like 5 of each of these. I bought Quince & Co. like 3 or 4 weeks in a row. So
those colors together are so pretty.
Well, they're not. Well, they definitely, they all lend to my skin tone. They won't be going together because I'm really plain. I like solid colors. I like timeless pieces. This is what I'm going, that's how I'm going to explain myself. I like to wear timeless pieces that never age. So it's Quince & Co. Sparrow. And they are just gorgeous. I think mauve is like my color this year. Oh my. And this purpley mauve. I don't know. It's not quite lilac.
It's like a, it's sort of lilac.
What do they call it? Venice. Yeah. Kind of grapey. Yeah. So. Burgundy-ish. Port.
Port. More definitely wine. Port. Yes.
Yeah. It's, yeah. So, I have some tops that I'm planning. I'm swatching to make a pattern out of this. So, this is the Nanny Berry colorway. I'm swatching to write a pattern, hopefully. Ooh. Hopefully it won't take me forever. I don't know.
Cool.
I don't know what I'm doing. I mean, I'm just... Yeah, I don't.
I thought you said sweater. I'm just thinking.
Well,
about
no, it'll be like tank top or some sort of summery shirt. Okay. But like as far as designing, I don't know what I'm doing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm,
yeah.
All right. Is that it? For that? Should we do song?
We didn't do.
Oh yeah.
Knit chat. Let's
talk about that.
Yeah. So I'm a knitting teacher.
She's my knitting teacher.
Yeah.
At like 2:30 in the morning.
Yes. We need a few hours of quiet before we go to bed. So that's when I knit.
5 or 6.
She sews.
Or 7.
I don't think I ever did that much time. So anyway, I'm a knitting teacher. I teach at my local yarn store. A lot of right-handers, they don't know that I'm left-handed because I can teach right-handers. But I am a true lefty knitter. I really, truly am. Everything that I knit is mirrored to right-handed knitters. And I also teach at knitchats.com. You may not know of knitchats.com. We're fairly new. It's exciting though. We are, knitchats.com is an online platform that does real live on-demand knitting help. We have a virtual help table for knitters. You can give us a call and you'll get a number of us teachers who are available. Go check it out. Try it out for free. Everybody is super friendly. Everybody is really knowledgeable. There are some who are designers, some who are local yarn store owners, or former local yarn store owners. It's a lot of fun. So,
and there's a YouTube page.
Yeah, they do have a YouTube page.
Yeah, and videos on Instagram too.
Yes. So anytime you need help, we understand. We understand. Yeah, so it's by knitters, it's for knitters. And we have a good time. We have knit alongs. The current knit along that is going is the Tin Can Knit Strange Pullover. So if you're interested in getting into color work, that would be a great chance for you to get involved with Knit Chats. It's sponsored, I believe, by Tin Can Knits, so there are prizes available. So hop on over, join in. The more the merrier. They're excited. So. Should we move on to sewing? Do you have yeah. sewing?
I have a couple of things. So I just had a baby 3 months ago. And so I have a lot of clothes that fit me. So I've kind of been on a clothing garment sewing kick. So I have a few things. And this one is the Ella Top by Leola Patterns. I got it off at IndieSew.com. And if you don't know about IndieSew, they have they sell fabric as well. They have they list in IndieSew patterns, but they also have, which are really really great patterns that they test out. So I trust a lot of their patterns that are up there. But they also have a nice database of just blog posting for help on sewing, different sewing techniques and stuff like that, and different hacks that they can do with some of their patterns and things like that. Oops. Oh no. So this is the Leola Patterns Ella Top. And I did it in this. This is a hand screened printed linen. The little bird's in here. Put a bird on it. And it's by Selena Mancurdy off of Etsy, and I'll have a link down there. I actually got this to make something else. I was going to make a headboard with it, but I never did. So, but I really like this pattern. It has French seams throughout. It's not finished, obviously. I need to bind the edges, the armholes, and the hem still. And so I just did a bias tape that I made myself out of a linen that I had. But the pattern, it has a contrasting yoke in the back, and it has, I'm not going to remember what this is called now.
Cute.
And it has
this flap?
Yeah, I can't remember what they call that.
I don't know.
It has this right here. Yeah. I can't remember what it's called. And then, it also has a pleat in the back. And so it's just a nice little pattern. You can do the whole thing on your sewing machine if you don't have a serger. You can do a lot of things on your sewing machine if you don't have a serger. But this one is nice because all of the edges, all of the seams are finished. And so you can just do the whole thing on your sewing machine. And it has darts in the front, which I still need to figure out the right placement for darts for me, because this is the first time I've ever done them. But it does have darts, so there is some shaping in the top. But it's really, really nice in linen. I think it would be a really great summer top for linen.
Have you tried it on since you've had Isana? Like, to see if the darts are now okay for you?
I don't know.
You should try it on. I mean, you don't have to right now, but like...
I won't do it now. but it's just a nice little top that you can do a lot of different details with. I have a couple planned with the, I think it was the Wonderland by Cotton Steel. I'm going to do one of the Wonderland prints. I think it was Wonderland prints on the bottom. And then I'm going to do a black and white stripe on the yoke for summer in rayon.
I have a confession. I quit following like all of the fabric stuff, because I have such a huge stash that I haven't used.
Oh.
And I, like, if I see it, I want to buy it. So I just quit following everything. I have no idea. I did see a few things by Cotton and Steel recently and by Camelot Fibers, yeah. But I was like, hurry up, scroll.
I love the Wonderland wine. It's so cute. I do have a fabric stash now.
Yeah.
I never did, and I would always make fun of her and...
For having a stash.
No, I have one.
You don't have a stash like some people.
Stashes are cool.
They are now.
Not mustaches.
Not that stash.
Not that kind of stash. So, and then this one is the Hey June Union Street Tee. And I got this one originally because I've just kind of been going back to... When I was pregnant, I had some basic maternity t-shirts that were loaned or given to me by somebody. And I decided I wanted to try to make some t-shirts. I had never done it before. But I have to do full bust adjustments for pretty much everything. And somebody on Instagram had told me that Heijun has an FBA piece that goes on some of her patterns now. And so that was why I got the Union Street tee. It's not done. I don't like to hem things. Hemming is the worst. So a lot of my things are unhemmed, but I will get it done. The fabric is from, I don't have it right here, but I can put it, I'll have a link to it. But it's from stylishfabric.com, and it's a rayon, a poly rayon jersey, I think. And it's one of the first times I've ever done stripes, so I actually did get the sides matched up pretty good. And
happy accident.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Well, the sleeves, I actually got one sleeve is matched and the other one is not. So, whatever. Nobody's going to look that close, right?
She spit her past Vera, like, as soon as I put it back in.
Okay.
So I really like the that she has that FBA piece in there. It makes it really easy, and I don't have to, you know, hack my pattern piece anyway. But I think it only goes up to a double D. So if you need anything bigger than that, then Cashmere Patterns has really great patterns for larger busts. That I think they have a T-shirt that would probably work.
I just wish I had any.
And I'm still sewing for winter because it's been so cold here forever. And this one is the Heijun Aurora tee, and it is
some fleecy.
What do you call this style?
It's
a dolman top. It has a dolman sleeve, so it goes together really fast because you don't have to do any set-in sleeves. You sew the sleeve. It's a drop. I think it's like a drop shoulder, is what they call it. I'm not really sure. But you sew this bottom sleeve part on flat. So it's really fast. And then you just zip right up the sides. And I love the fit of this. and this fabric is from Stylish Fabric. My facing keeps flipping up because I didn't change the tension on my serger when I did the bottom part here. My needles, I think. And so it flips up a little bit, but it's not a big deal. But it is interfaced. You could probably leave that off.
So did you figure that out?
If you have a thicker fabric.
That it's not the interfacing?
I don't think it's the interfacing.
It's
your
tension?
I think it was the tension in my needles. Because if you pull on it, the stitches move.
Really,
so that kind of, to me, signals that it might be too tight on the needles on my serger. And so the fabric is from Stylish Fabric. It is...
If you have a lot of pets, you're not going to want this fabric.
Yeah, it does...
it attracts.
Everything sticks to it. I have to use a lint roller on it before I go anywhere.
It's cute, though.
It's super comfortable. It's a stretch jersey, and it has like a wool... it says a wool hachi brush to it, so it's really, really soft. And I've washed it several times, and it's washed really, really well. And I've worn it. I wore it for about a week after I made it.
Yeah.
So I did wash it, though.
I'll wear this tomorrow.
Yeah. So, yeah. I wore it a lot. I love the pattern. It is so awesome. And, hold on. I have to look up her name.
Okay. Ooh, what's that? Oh, the Aurora tee. That's cute.
Oh, also, the Aurora tee, she does have some side insert panels that you can put in that wrap around the front of the shirt. So you could do like a contrasting fabric that wraps around into here. I haven't tried it yet. The Heijun owner, Adriana, she will answer all of your emails. She's been really great with all the questions that I've asked her.
Now that you said it, because you're going to send a flood.
An influx of emails to her.
Yeah.
But she answered all of my questions, and she answered a few of them on Instagram and a few of them on email. And she was really, really awesome. I even asked her about a ready-to-wear top that I had a picture of that I sent her and asked her how to replicate that with this pattern. And I haven't tried it yet, but because I wanted to try it without changing it first. But so she is really, really great and helpful. And
that's more than worth the price of the patterns.
Oh. And then I have, yeah, the help on the patterns can be so amazing if people are willing to help. And then I have another Aurora tee. It is
beautiful. Oh my goodness. I love this fabric.
It's my favorite.
Oh my goodness. It's my favorite.
See, there's that tension.
Oh yeah, this again. Is a drop shoulder because it's like.
Yeah, is that what they call it?
I think about it in knitting. I just did a drop shoulder sweater as well recently.
Yeah. So. I really like the drop shoulder. I don't know. I think it's really flattering. The dolman sleeve is really flattering. On me at least. I don't know about everybody, but
well, it doesn't work for everyone,
I would think it would be pretty flattering. This is a double knit from Style Maker Fabrics.
It's so beautiful. I see why it's called a double knit.
It's in the charcoal color. It looks black here.
It's like a brushed look, kind of heathered.
Kind of heathered, yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's called Romantic Roses Double Knit Charcoal. But it sews so amazing. It doesn't slip around or anything like that. And it's got a kind of a hefty feel to it. A double knit usually is a little bit thicker. And the print is really pretty. And it's really nice. I still have to hem this one too. And I need to cut off some threads up here.
It's not an FO yet, so.
Yeah, I wasn't sure if I was going to keep the neckline in here or if I was going to redo. I did just a double on my cover stitch.
Needle?
I did a double stitch around there. And I might take it out because I think I had the tension wrong on that too. In some places, you can't even tell it's there. But the pattern is amazing. I really like it. I actually do have another one at home. I didn't bring it. I used too slinky of a fabric, and I don't think it worked very well. And I think I'm just going to use it for pajamas.
too drapey.
It's way too drapey, yeah. But you could leave this bottom part off, this long bottom sleeve part off. You can leave that off and just hem this shorter sleeve to make a short sleeve.
Would that be like a cap sleeve? Or does it...
No, because it's a little bit longer than a cap sleeve.
Oh, okay.
Cap sleeve is like, I think this one is. But... So the other one that I made is a short sleeve one because I wanted to try that out, and but I don't think I don't like the slinky feeling to the fabric, but this is amazing. So yeah, and I'll put a link to this too. I'm pretty sure I found this on their website. I'll have a link to that.
I have just some quick planning. I plan to do the Biscayne blouse in this Barry J. shirting fabric.
I love Barry J.
me too. I think it's drapey enough.
Yeah.
Right? For a woven?
Oh, I think so, yeah.
To work for the Biscayne blouse? I don't know. Yeah. It's by Hey June, the Biscayne blouse.
It's so cute.
It's really pretty. I like
the detail.
The split with the placket, but no buttons.
No, I don't remember the buttons.
Is it still a placket if it doesn't have buttons?
No, I think it's depends on how it's sewn.
I've
never done a placket.
Okay.
I will though, because I have a fabric.
It has a great detail. So and then I have this mystery fabric that I bought from someone online. And I was told that it was a sweater knit, which I have no idea what that actually means. Maybe they don't either. They're from California. Sweaters in Nebraska must have a different connotation than sweaters in California. I don't know. But I have no idea what to do with this fabric. It's beautiful. It has a lot of drape. And you can kind of see through it. So if you have any ideas...
It's a knit.
It's a knit. Definitely.
It's pretty stretchy.
It's really stretchy. So So if you have any ideas of what I can do with this, I have 1 yard, which I'm a small person, so that's not going to matter.
I love summer sewing because I
don't know what to do with
it. You know, you can buy less fabric for a lot of summer things.
So what do you have planned?
So I have a couple of new fabrics here that I got. This one is from Style Maker Fabrics. I really like Style Maker. They have really good, they just have really nice fabrics that you can get. And I like to shop their salvage yard sale because they have some pretty good deals on there. I found some things on the salvage yard before. I got some twill last year to make some shorts with that I'm going to do this year. But I got the twill off of their salvage yard, and I think generally it's like 2 yards or under. I don't think I've seen anything over that, but they usually knock off a couple of dollars off of their salvage yard stuff. So I have seen some things in their salvage yard that they will sell on their regular section. They just have a smaller piece of it left. And so I got, this is a French terry. And
it was showing up so beautifully
earlier. It's sparkly. Got a little bit darker. I think you can see the sparkles.
Yeah, you can see the sparkles.
It's sparkly and it's really smushy, and I think it'll be really nice. I'm probably going to do an Aurora tee out of this also. It's going to be too warm for summer and probably too warm for spring because I don't think we're really going to have spring here. But it'll be really nice for wintertime, and so I'm excited to do that.
What are you talking about? Today is spring. Today is the day.
That's true. Today is.
It's like the only
day. The day of spring is today. And then I also got, I keep holding my papers way up there. I also got, this is a Japanese double gauze. A Japanese double gauze.
That's beautiful.
Scattered dot navy. It looks kind of purpley, but it's, the dots are purple, but the background is navy. And then there's these cute little butterflies.
And what are those? Oh, butterflies.
Cute little butterflies in kind of like a mustardy yellow color. And I'm going to do the Lakeside Pajamas by Grayline Studios out of these because I get really hot at night. And I think, or out of this, because I think this will be a really nice fabric to wear at nighttime.
Yeah.
And I still need to get something to bind the edges with, but I'm probably going to get like a lawn or something, just because double gauze can be a bear cat to make bias strips out of, or so I've heard. I've never done it before, but I did send her an email as well, and asked her about something about the binding the edges, and she had mentioned, you know, maybe use like a lawn or a cotton or something like that. So, because I don't want to do pre-made bias because it's so scratchy, and it's kind of fun to make your own bias. And then I also have, that one is also from Style Maker. And then I have this, oops, I have, this is a Robert Kaufman, just knocked all my notes on the ground.
My son is looking at me like, hey, mom.
She's like, hey, mom. This is a Robert Kaufman chambray. It's in the indigo colorway. They also have a black one. It's their dot, in chambray dot. And this is from Pearl Soho. It's my first Pearl Soho purchase. I want everything on their website, by the way.
Yeah, me too.
And it's so, it's nice and thin. I had never gotten a chambray before, so I was really excited to try this. And I'm going to do the Cheyenne tunic.
Afterwards, with your remnants, you should do bubble shorts for
Isana. Oh, that would be so cute.
Oh my goodness, the cutest bubble shorts ever.
So I'm going to do the Cheyenne tunic by Hey June. Oops. I just dumped something on the floor again.
Your phone.
So I'm going to do the Cheyenne tunic by Hey June in this. And I think this would be really nice for summertime as well, depending on, you know, what length your sleeve is. So I think I have like 2 yards of this. I just unfolded the whole thing.
Yeah, it's going to be perfect. So what's this stripey, glittery?
And then
glittery?
I have this metallic striped jersey. And this is from Style Maker as well. And it has, I think they call it jade. It's the color is jade and hunter. So I think the jade is the turquoise. And then there's like a hunter green kind of shimmery stripe that runs through the black. And this is just a jersey. It's a jersey knit. And I don't know what I'm going to do out of this yet. I was thinking a t-shirt. I might do the Union Street tee with it. But I love that sparkle in there. It's so pretty. I've seen a dress on Instagram made out of this too. So maybe I'll do a dress.
Ooh. No. Wow. That'd be neat.
Yeah. So, but yeah. And it's just, it's really nice and soft and stretchy. Pretty. Washed up really well. So every now and then, I don't do this very often just because children.
Time.
But I do, every now and then I'll do like some embroidery hand stitching type things. And for, this was actually supposed to be a Christmas present, and I didn't get it finished because I totally underestimated how long it was going to take me to do this. But this is the Squirrel's Happy Tree Home by... This is the Squirrel's Happy Tree Home Quiet Book by Little Deer on Etsy. And it is just adorable. The pattern is really detailed. She has some great fun little details in there. Like there's a little table for the squirrel to sit on. And there's a little bed that you can put the squirrel inside. And she has other little animals you can buy on there to put in there. And
So, oh, you have your squirrel.
Oh, and then this is the little... This is Squirrel, Sammy Squirrel. She's very cute, or he. And my kids love the little squirrel. And so it's just an adorable pattern. It has, you know, little sections, the outsides of the houses and then or the tree and then the inside of the tree. And so I just take the pattern and I traced it on tissue paper that I reused from a gift from Christmas.
Ooh,
and then,
that's
and I
a
did
good
it,
idea.
Yeah, we're nice little reuse idea. And I don't know if we can show the pattern or not.
I was just... Oh, that's right.
Sure.
Okay.
I thought about that. I was like, I don't know how.
Yeah.
So...
Tissue paper.
Yeah, tissue paper. Great idea. You can... I use my... I have a little... The Cricut Bright Pad, I think it's called. And that made it super easy to trace it on there because I had never done any, I've done doll faces and things like that, but I've never done any hand stitching embroidery that was this big and detailed before. So it worked. Here's my baby.
Oh, she's mad.
She's trying to get that piece of
her. Give me that
piece. So it worked really well too. And then what I do is I take the tissue paper and put it on top and I stitch through the tissue paper onto the felt. And then you can just tear it off. I mean, you have to do it, you know, slower because you don't want your stitches to stretch out. But you just tear it off, and it works really, really well to do it that way instead of having to transfer anything onto the felt or guess where you... I mean, you can guess if you want. I'm too detail-oriented to do that. That's too panicky for me, but more power to you. But
I have too many kids. Too many things going on. Oh,
yes.
I can see so much going awry. Oh,
yes.
Man.
So I used... Benzie Designs Wool Rayon Felt Blend. I've never gotten wool felt before. I started this really awesome this really awesome advent calendar a couple years back. But I bought...
No. It was longer than 2 years.
3 years? It might have been 3 years.
I don't know. I was on the phone with you once and you're like, I just melted it.
I'm just... Yeah. I used, you know, regular felt from... Because... It's so hard to find the wool felt in stores. I've never seen anything that isn't the thick felted sheets from Joann's. I've never seen anything at Joann's before. And so I ordered, so I was making this advent calendar and I melted my fleece and it melted onto my iron because I never checked my iron settings.
It was polyester.
It's polyester felt, yeah.
And
it melted, and I did it 2 years in a row, and I was going to finish it on the third year, and I decided to just throw it away, which I almost never
sad.
Do.
That was sad.
I really don't do that.
I was so sad when you did that, but I also didn't see it in person. You only sent me a picture.
Oh, it was so cool. It was this big Christmas tree, and you put on these little, little Christmas balls, and it's so cute. Little...
Snowflakes.
I think it was snowflakes. Yeah, I was gonna say
in the
they're little circles of felt, and they're supposed to be snowflakes, and they're so adorable. But I could put that link in here too if anybody really wants to try. But anyway, Ben Z Designs felt is amazing, and she has a ton of different colors. She also has floss. You can order packages that come with embroidery floss, and that match the felt perfectly, and so it's really awesome. On this little crown here, I made
this one right here.
So this little pattern is so cute. And
you're looking at the squirrel.
Someday
I'll
see
the squirrel.
I know I can see. Someday I'll get it done. I'm gonna try to start working on it because my kids really want it. They play with the squirrel all the time. So this little crown I also made out of Benzie felt. I did a newborn photo shoot with my 3-month-old when she was littler, and all I did to make this was I had seen some really cute crowns on Etsy, and you know, for photo props, but I decided I'd try to make my own. And so all I did was I found a crown template online. I just found one that I liked, and I printed it out, and I reduced the size until it got to be small enough to be to fit on her head.
How did you know?
I had to just guess.
So you can kind of tell.
You can kind of tell what 50% is going to be, and then if you think that's going to be too small, then you can go a little bit bigger. And so I think I maybe did like 60 or something like that. I don't remember. And then I measured her head, and then I measured the length of the crown when I printed it out. And
do you print it out on paper first? And then...
Yep, I printed it out on just regular computer paper. And then once I had the circumference of her head on the paper, on the crown that I printed out, then I cut that out and I used it as a template.
She's sucking on the wrong end.
Oh, baby, that's so gross.
Yeah.
And I used it as a template to cut out the felt. And then the little butterflies, I just printed off. It was actually a Martha Stewart thing. I printed off a Martha Stewart thing.
Oh, and traced them?
Actually, these, I did find a Martha Stewart butterfly that I cut out. I didn't have the patience to cut all the little butterflies out. So I used, for this one, after I realized how long it was going to take me to cut all the little butterflies out, which probably wouldn't have been that long, honestly.
But longer than desired.
At the time, it was too long. I was pregnant.
It's teasy.
And I didn't want to do it. So I used my Cricut Maker, and I just used one of their free patterns. And you can look through their free patterns, and you don't have to do that project. They have a bunch of free projects. You can just use their cutting file, and I found a butterfly cutting file, and I found a couple of different little butterflies, and I did that. And then I did a blanket stitch around the top and around the bottom of the crown. I did 2 layers of felt on the crown just to give it a little more structure. But honestly, the felt is pretty thick. So it might have been fine with just 1 layer, but I wanted to do the blanket stitch around the top because I think the blanket stitch is really pretty. And it didn't make sense to do it on just 1 layer. So
it really finishes it nicely. I really like it.
It's so pretty.
Cute.
And so I used the felt that she sent along, and and I hand stitched the butterflies on. So it was a fun little project, and she's very cute in it.
Well, if you've stuck with us this far, thank you so much for coming, and we're so glad that you've been here. We'll probably do a podcast about once a month because we live about 45 minutes to an hour away from one another. But this is a really good excuse for us to get together and share the things that we've been doing with one another and other people, because we're both home a lot. So it's kind of nice to have a community. So,
okay.
There's baby.
She's so cute. She's getting sad now. So thank you for coming to watch us, and we'll
join us in our Ravelry group, and you can find us on Instagram and Ravelry as well. So, bye.
Bye. Everything is awesome.
We're
That. We're both left-handed.
We're left-handed.